Okay, so let's say we do not have an option of finding the repositories from that particular location, but yes, we can change our thought process. We can look out for the startups. Let's say if you're focusing on India, I'll look out for the companies, Indian startups or Indian big tech product companies, let's say, or Flipkart. Great, I have 48 repositories from Flipkart. So let's take a use of this. This is issue. This is searching for code. Username and org size. 4 stars created, WebOS created, pushed. Searching for code, user, searching issue pull request. Okay, fine. Then we have performance, React Native Web, cross platform, list view, recycler. I'll just go one by one repositories. 48 repositories won't take much time. And I know Flipkart is an Indian startup. Great, Swifty, Flipkast. Nice, here I have used by 104 people. Sorry, 1400. People here, I have 14 contributors onto this particular repository. So at the org level, if someone is a contributor for such repositories, then definitely poachable candidates. Java and JavaScript, nice. I get the language also of repository, in which language this particular repository is written. 13 contributors, TypeScript, and yeah, Perl, HTML, JavaScript shell, Java, JavaScript, contributors, number of contributors here, and languages. So number of contributor and again languages. Number of contributor. So here maybe one person only, and then languages. 18 contributors and then languages. Then languages. So yeah, this kinds of works out. Then one by one, I can always go back to the profile and fetch in the details. So as I logged in, I could see whoever has mentioned their email ID to the public. We can view that. Okay, so this candidate did not mention. You see, most of them are from India and from Flipkart and worked on those particular repositories.
Hi Shiv. Like the people who have not mentioned their email ID in public, like from where do we get that?
We'll come to that. Let's finish off our search part, direct search part on GitHub, what all the options we have it. Then we'll go there.
Okay,
so this is by repository. We were able to fetch it. Then come to the searching the code, repository and issues we did. Then come to the code. Maybe definitely you'll have to explore on your own also to get more insights and more hands on how GitHub direct searches would work. AutoCAT in file name, path matches. User, organization, repository. So the combination of search with the users or organization repository. That we just did it. Search by language, Okay, you can search for a code based on what language it's written. Let's see what is this. Okay, language, okay. This we know, we are giving multiple languages. Function size, file type. That's fine. So 730 contributors in linguistic YML. Location, okay, location of that particular file, that's a file location. So path colon and okay, something like if I say path colon, okay. Location Bangalore. And then language Java colon forward slash path resume. Let's come back there. File type, readme, and then path. Matches the readme files with the word AutoCAD. Okay, we'll go Bangalore, file name, readme path that are located at a root level of repositories. AutoCAD. Before that, language Perl. Console app, public language JavaScript, element language display, greater than less than ranges, this we know. Let me just try to see what is a XPath of it. Shukumar 400 forward slash CV. Okay. Okay, these are the things which we can't use. That's okay, but yeah, try to see if there is a way, if this can work out. Considering code search, anyways, we are doing it by using languages and then issues. I would not really suggest, but let's see. Organization and team, nice. Team, org name, owner matches issue with org name and the owner team is mentioned. Okay, team Mayork is open, is PR, matches all pull request where at your team and ops is mentioned. Okay, let's use this. This seems to be interesting. Team or name, team name. I don't know what could be the team names, but let's take a guess. Or name. Flipkart. Team name. Payments. Let's say pay. Or let me keep it in caps. Payments, enterprise, search, product. Yeah. Let's see further. Org name and team name, otherwise commenter from so and so. So the team mentions username. Involves username, LinkedIn, repository, desktop or stop is open. Linked PR matches open issue, desktop or desktop repository that link to pull request by closing a references. Label, help wanted, broken. Bug fix, project GitHub, linguistic. Let me see in case if this only works. Status failure. Okay. Dot dot matches a pull request opened on May 15th. With a failed status, created something after May 15th. And 1st of May 15th and 30th of May 15th. Let's see if this still works. As I mentioned yesterday in our yesterday's call, it used to work a long back, but now for some reason it has gone. But let me just keep this much first and try to see. Okay, repositories are coming, but user option. Okay, user option is also coming. Let's see, 2018 or 2019. Language Java, location Bangalore. Okay, we wanted someone who has created something, but definitely this would not be a profile created. Let's have one cross check. Most recently joined. we need a profiles in case if this is working, then it should only give a list of profiles who have joined before May 2019, 30th of May 2019. And we have sorted with most recently joined. So let's see in case if it is working. Good. Yeah, I think we are there with so many trial and errors. So let me just take 2018. Someone who has created something or profile before 2018, language Java, location Bangalore. So this should show a list of candidates who has created at least before 2018 and not anything before after 2018. So I'll go with most recently joined again. So in case if you're getting a list of profiles after 2018, then this is not working. But if you're getting a profiles at least on or before, May 30th, 2018, then looks like we got the catch. So yeah, 2018. First repository, Rahul, December, but otherwise, at least it is before 2018, created three other repositories, September, Shamar, yep, created profile on or before 2018, May 2018, in fact, 30th of May 2018, this looks, seems to be working. Created 28th May. Yep. Joined 27th May. Nice. So yeah, yesterday someone was asking in case if you can give a candidates who would have created their profile between those two date ranges. So maybe as I mentioned in our yesterday's call, sometimes the positioning of the particular keywords over here does matter in GitHub. That is something I observed earlier also. So yesterday we did try this, but it did not work. But now if you see created, did we try yesterday? I think we have tried it. So here it is. So what's the difference here? Here we have used after and before marks. Here we did not use after and before. We just gave only the date ranges. We did not give after and we did not give before. What's a minor difference we have done in this string is only the date ranges. So let's modify this date ranges. In our yesterday search, which did not work, this one. So location Canada, language Java, language PHP. So it would give Java or PHP and from Canada. And this is what we have used yesterday, which did not work. So we'll still go copy paste the same string. It did not work. But now let's remove this one and just give 31st Jan 2015 to 31st December 2018, dot, dot. Yep. Now let's say we'll go with most recently joined so that we do not get any of the profiles who have joined after 31st of December 2018 and see in case if this is working. If it is working, then finally we have got it. Anyways, when it is sorted by most recently joined, so I don't think we'll have to go for a further pages, but still let's go for some further pages. Let's complete this first, then we'll come here. So what's a search query? Someone who has joined after 2015, that would come in the last pages, and because we are sorting with the most recently joined, so someone who has joined on or before 31st December 2018. Okay, 2018. Okay, yeah, 28 December 2018, most accurate. December 2018, most accurate. So 30th of December 2018, too good. Thirty-first of December. They are the most dedicated guys. Instead of doing party on 31st December, they are creating their GitHub profiles. Nice. So let's slightly modify. So let's say instead of 31st of December, let's say 25th of December. On a day of Christmas. And then again, go most recently joined. Looking for new opportunities. Nice. 2018. So 18th of December, 9, which is before 25th. 19 December. 20th. 20th. Repositories created. So this is a company page. So let's ignore this. 21st. 22nd, 23rd, 25th. That's amazing. So this is working most accurately. So yeah, as I mentioned, like sometimes positioning also does matter, but now we did write where we have created at the last, but yesterday might be we were missing something on or before. So in GitHub searches, definitely in strings, we have to keep on trying various options. So yeah, this is what is working. Location Canada, language Java, language PHP. So it would give either Java or PHP who has created within this particular dates. So I think we got our biggest answer just to fight in for the year of experience. All right, I'll just take a pause here. Any questions?
So please summarize once.
Okay, so let's say within this search only, when we give location Canada, we get the profiles only from Canada. Similarly, we can give two different location so that we get profile either from Canada or from Sweden. Similarly for language, language:Java or language:PHP. So again, we get either Java or PHP candidates and then create it. We are not using on or before signs over here. We are just using we are just using a specific date range. Someone who has created after 31st of Jan 2015 dot dot, someone who has created something, their profile before 31st of December 2018, and that's where it's giving. As soon as we mention this particular dot dot, like something like this, let's say created, and then created like this. We don't use dot dot here. We just used created someone 2015. It's again not after or not before. We just use this particular search. Though we got the results yesterday, but those were not that accurate result, only within that particular date ranges. Those are something they have created something or the other, but again, it doesn't mean that the person who has created something before 2018, definitely they would have created something else also after 2018. So that results were also coming in. I would not go again in depth to the back, but instead of giving two created, if we give something, just dot dot and make it location. And then we get the additional list of actually profile created before on or before that particular date ranges, so that we also know how to catch for the year of experiences. Yeah, that's it so far. And then additionally, we just seen Google or Amazon or AWS or Microsoft or Twitter. What are the additional keywords we are mentioning like this without any commands? Those are the particular keywords which has been captured by GitHub and displays the results of a candidate who would have mentioned in the text part of it here, something like working at Google or Amazon or LinkedIn or Twitter. So let me just keep this also. So maybe string has become little longer. Let's keep it little shorter. Okay, so we get it. Anyways, we have the way how we can break this particular rule also of giving that particular limited. Let's say if I'm giving these many companies, but it's not taking. So we just give these many companies. So how many searches it's taking? Okay, one operator, second operator, third operator, four operator, five operator. And then maybe six, seven, eight, up to eight keywords it's taking, keywords or operator. But maybe to break that, if I give this particular search over here, it won't take. Let's see in case if we can break by removing space after or. Space before or remains as it is, but space after or goes off. Sometimes in some of the portal, we come across a limitation of these particular keywords. And let's see in case if this works now. So just to break that limitation. Yeah.
Location spelling is wrong.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see now in that case. So it was giving only from Canada. If the spelling of location for Sweden was wrong, but still it was giving us a result in previous example, then this it might have been giving a result only from Canada. So let's see now. second. LOCA created. So let's give this string first. LOCATION location. Let me come to home page. Nothing. Location. So let's remove these brackets.
It's saying more than 5 operators are used, right?
Yeah, we'll come to that. So let's keep only 3 and see if it works. I assume it will work. Yes. So let's see if there is a workaround of breaking this the way we break sometimes in LinkedIn. So whatever the space before or remains as it is, and after or goes off. Whatever the space after or goes off and before or remains as it is. So or we used with brackets. In first go. So second example, we use without bracket. Up. So let's do this. Okay, let's remove one or the other location and let's keep it a little simple. Now let's remove this. No, it's not taking. So I think we have an additional limitation now. Earlier it was working, but now it's not working.
I believe GitHub doesn't take a bracket.
Yeah, in some example, yes, some example, no. So we have to keep on trying whether it takes a bracket or not. Additional keywords. Let's say Google or Amazon. This gives us. So maybe additional keywords, whatever we are giving, let's keep that particular thing limited. Anyways, companies is something one by one we can keep on targeting. Don't really have to target all companies at once. So maybe in first go, I'll just go Google, Amazon, or AWS. In second go, I'll take additional list of companies, Microsoft, Twitter, or Facebook. Yeah, maybe one by one, I'll just go and take it from there. All right, that's about the direct search. Now someone was asking, now moving on to the next, any further doubts or confusion on this search bar? Complete dive deep into the direct searches of GitHub. I think we have done decent enough dive deep. Any confusion, any questions?
Shiv, I was asking about that email thing, like once the profiles there don't have the email.
Yeah, we are coming there. Apart from that, on direct searches, any further questions? Searching by repository, searching by org. So repository is something really interesting. Where we
just briefly summarize.
So how do I summarize?
The initial part, actually.
Which part?
When we started off with the direct search, like we started off with the, you know, today's session, ideally, just the brief first part, actually.
No, nothing. What we have done, we have just gone to the advanced search. We just come to home first, log in into the GitHub. After logging into the GitHub, let's say you come to home. And let's say if you want to go to the advanced search, just type Java. Then you came here. Over here, you type on an advanced search. So as you know, in a user option, we don't really have an options of choosing a multiple languages. So here you have a search bar. And then from here, you pick up the languages. Maybe one language at a time you can pick up, language and the location. Let's say Bangalore. And then search. So you get the list of profiles. And then additionally, I believe you're there in the session, right?
Yes, Shiv.
Yeah, after that, if you're still confused, maybe you can recap on the videos.
No, after this, you did some, you know, options where you went to that repositories and things like that.
Cheat sheet. Then cheat sheet, you have arrows over here. From here, you go to those particular options, particular pages, and try to see additional operators are over here and which operator works in which combination. So we have covered pretty much in detail. So maybe once I upload the video, you can please refer to that.
Hey Shiv, I have a quick question on search string.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say search string we were using Java and PHP. So we used language colon Java and language colon PHP. So that is for OR or that is for AND?
That is for OR. It would give me either a Java or PHP candidate. It won't give me Java and PHP. It will give me Java or PHP. And additionally, okay, if I need some of the language Java or PHP, let's say mobile, or I'll just create one more string. So now we get a list of profiles from, so these would give me candidates from location Canada or Sweden, people who are working on Java or PHP, and then created a profile between these two different dates. And people in a text part, they would have mentioned working at Google or Amazon or AWS or Samsung. So let's give us this much of search. The search is getting a little bigger. I'll come to home. Okay, so we get 25 users. Okay. So.
And similar way, Shiv, if you have to do the AND search, then how we would write Java and PHP if you have to find candidates who have both the languages?
Okay, let's say I'll just remove this company. So one language we gave, Java. So let's say if you wanted to do additionally along with Java, you need PHP, just remove language colon, keep PHP.
Okay, got it. Okay.
Okay, again, they would have mentioned in the text part like this, like over here. If they have not mentioned in the text part over there, you might not get it. So if you see now we have 19 users. Again, from Java, 19 user, their primary language of code, but also they have written PHP in the text part over here.
Okay, so to summarize, if we have to find candidates with more than one languages, we would just use language and colon and the language name, space the other language.
Yeah, just space the other language is enough. So whatever the keywords we are giving without any command, like PHP, Google or Amazon or AWS or Samsung. So definitely it's giving us a results of, let's say,